Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Goffstown Girls Basketball. My name is Al DeRusso. I'll be announcing tonight's game. And along with me is Scott Gross, doing the color commentating.
How you doing, Al?
I am doing wonderful.
I guess we have to start the broadcast off by also saying thank you to Butch Gifford, who's going to be our cameraman for tonight, and Kevin Hero, who's going to be assisting us with our graphics package. So we got a complement of four people working this game. And we wouldn't be able to do it without our support.
That's true. Thank you very much. We get started here tonight. Goffstown's riding a four-game winning streak coming into tonight's game, and Laconia has been on the downturn after opening the season with a win. They've lost six straight, so jumping at center for Goffstown is going to be Casey Britton, Doucette. And the tap is controlled by Laconia.
So, Al, it looks like Goffstown's been riding, a four-game winning streak. So it looks like they found those combinations of players that are, you know, that they were looking for from the beginning of the season.
They're looking at youth is what they're looking at right now. Three-point shot from the outside. Doesn't get anything. Rebound.
That was a bit of a push by number three, Al.
Look at Brennan. She did a great job at staying with that ball all the way through.
It looks like number three of Laconia did, like, pushed off, but it wasn't called for a foul.
I know. Inside to Britton Doucette. Outside to Edmonds. Brennan set the point back up again. Looks like they're playing a 1-3. Well, I'm not quite sure what they're playing. Man, Brennan with the ball, back to the corner, three-point shot by Perez. It's off, rebound by Walsh for Goffstown. Get in the middle, Doucette to Walsh.
Yeah, Perez was wide open on that play, but I don't think Britton
saw it. Kick
it out
to her again, sideline jumper is good. Goffstown full court pressure. Man-to-man pressure. Trap at midcourt. Laconia breaks it. Starts to the basket and kicks it back outside. Three-point shot taken. No good. Rebound underneath by Walsh. She comes up. Gets it ahead to Perez. Nice throw underneath. Back outside. Walsh goes right down the middle. Shot no good. Rebound fought for, taken by Laconia.
That was a nice job by Walsh. You know, she faked the pass and then put up the shot, was wide open. Couldn't make the shot.
It worked for them quite well the other night. Oh, good hustle back that time by Walsh. They had a wide open player underneath the basket, Jared Kirk. And Walsh got back in time and knocked that ball out of bounds. Laconia, again looking, trying to penetrate, get inside to Kirk, and I think, yep, she did. Good defense by Goffstown that time, forcing the pass cross court.
Couldn't really tell there, as it wasn't that much offensive play on the Laconia, and I'm not sure if Goffstown, they're playing a zone, it looked like.
It's like a matchup zone.
Yep.
Cross court pass to Walsh. Back to Brennan. She's going to drive right through the middle. Nice job driving to the hoop. She did that the other night. She ended up at the foul line quite often.
That's one of the nice things. They've got some really good guard play here for the girls basketball team of Goffstown, and their dribble penetration does create a lot of opportunities for them.
You're right. And Brennan goes to the line for two shots. She didn't make the first one. She'll get a second. Foul was on Abby Crowell for Laconia. That's her first and team's first. Brennan's second shot. It's up. And that one's good. Again, the pressure. Oh, lost control. Picked up by Walsh. Great dribbling.
Woo!
Nice play.
Wow.
Oh, what a great steal and run to the basket.
That was a great crossover.
Again, the pressure from Goffstown on the press. Staying that way. Cross-court pass by Laconia. Taken. Shot in the inside.
Nice
good
box
rebound
out. Good
by Doucette that time.
That was a great box out by Doucette.
Brennan with the ball on the point. Over to Perez to Walsh. Three-point shot, no good. Great rebound that time by Doucette. Brennan controls. Perez inside. Edmonds kicked it out to Walsh.
All good looks, though, Al. I mean, the shots are not falling for Walsh, but all excellent looks.
She needs a few more drives to the basket to get her warmed up.
Yep.
Again.
Nice cut by number three.
Good boxing out that time, or a good push out by Edmonds, forcing her to go way outside. Lost control of her shot. Perez, outside shot, no good.
Again,
rebound,
good box out by Laconia, number 21. Here and there, fast break.
Two on one. Back again, and hustle back and basket. That time by Takas for Laconia. And we've got a 30-second timeout.
Goffstown needed to get a little bit better in terms of getting back on defense in that play.
Yeah, Laconia took off real quick. No fast break.
So far a pretty good start for Goffstown. They've had good open looks at some jump shots. Not many of them have fallen, but so far they've dribble penetrated, and that's created some opportunities as well.
Yeah, I think if they drive to the hoop a couple more times, it'll start to give them a little more confidence in their shots.
You got to be pleased, though, if you're the Goffstown coach. Defensively, you got to like what you're seeing. I mean, they're boxing out.
Good hustle around.
Right. Their hands are up in the air. They've had a couple of tipped balls and some turnovers.
Okay, Sierra Gilmore has checked into the game for Goffstown, number 21. And she replaces Casey Britton. Okay, Perez outside. Well, actually, Casey's still in the game. My bad. Walsh's outside shot up, no good. Rebound fought for underneath.
It's going to be over the back on Goffstown.
It's going to go underneath, and that foul is going to be on
13, I think.
Casey Britton. Doucette?
Nope. They're going to call it on Sierra Gilmore.
That's her first and the team's first. Again, the press break. Good job underneath that time by Gilmore.
And she kind of gave up that rebound, unfortunately.
Yep. Got a jump ball that goes to Goffstown, and we're going to have another
timeout.
30-second timeout by Goffstown. I think Ian's realizing that when they're doing that press that they got to get back quicker because.
And that's a smart play by the coach. You know, he's recognizing that, you know, it's a three-point game. He's got to make sure that the girls understand that in this situation they've got to get back on defense or else they're going to be giving up a lot of easy buckets.
Right. Edmonds got back that time. Was it Edmonds? Yeah, Casey Doucette got back that time and forced that ball to be missed underneath, so.
I like to see that in high school coaches. I tend to think that sometimes they let the kids play too much, but you know, they're young. They need instruction. They need to know what to do.
Hey, Walsh with the ball. Doucette inside to Gilmore. Kicks it back out to Walsh. Walsh on the point with it. Takes a three-point shot from the point. No good. Rebound fought for underneath and taken by Laconia.
Well, Walsh is not afraid to put up the shot, that's for sure. And so far, none of them have fallen down.
Oh, we're going to have a double dribble that time, or carry.
Carry, yeah. That's something you rarely see called in NBA games. It happens like every 15 seconds. But you just
don't
see
it.
They don't call it, yeah. And even in the boys' game, you know, you see a lot of the carries. It's how they're able to do some of these crazy moves. Nope.
And that time, way off the mark, was Perez. A rebound taken by Laconia.
Get on her.
Keeping the pressure on in the backcourt is Casey. Okay, Laconia's got the ball now. Goffstown's gone man-to-man.
Yeah, Laconia settled down. They had a little bit of a sketchy start, but they seem to be back in it now.
And we're going to have a basket. Good by Helen Takas.
And she got fouled, I think it was by number, it was Perez.
That was, no, Casey Brissett.
Okay. So this free throw could even it up at 5-5 if she makes it.
Shots away. No good. Rebound fought for. Taken by Goffstown. Good job.
Keep press and go. Push it.
You set. Good hustle. Brennan with it. Looking. Looks like Laconia's in a matchup type zone. They're trying to guard. It.
Yeah, there's opportunities there.
Outside by Doucette. A missed.
It's stolen by Walsh.
She's got control of the ball and taken away by Laconia. Good hustle back by Brennan.
Charge.
Oh, she got herself in a great position for an offensive foul.
Yeah, Laconia player lowered her shoulder. That's what drew it. I think if she didn't lower the shoulder, she might have gotten a block foul. But whenever you lower that shoulder, Al, you're going to get called for a charge.
They're coming into Goffstown. In the game is Cammy Durham. She gives Casey Britton Doucette a rest.
That's Zapala's second foul, by the way.
Good job by Gilmore. Nice. Oh, she should have. Outside, no good. Rebound fought for underneath. Nice job by Durham. Gets it over to Walsh. Tries to drive the baseline. No help. Brennan. Nice pick. That time by Gilmore. Kick back outside to Walsh. Walsh drives down underneath. Nothing there. Gets it back out. Perez to Brennan. Laconia is doing a good job cutting off those lanes underneath.
There's opportunities here if they can get the ball into Gilmore in the high post.
Yeah, what she has to do.
Great defense by Laconia. You got to give them credit.
They're doing a very good job. They're stopping.
So what I'm seeing, Al, is Laconia is doing an outstanding job going out on the perimeter. It looks like they're playing some sort of like a matchup type zone.
Yep.
But what Goffstown needs to do is they need to flash more than likely. It's Gilmore in this situation into the paint or the high post. And then from there, she's got to just spin and go to the hoop.
Exactly.
And she's not. She's getting the ball. She's making a move, but then she's quickly dishing it off again.
Yep. She had that drive underneath, and she kicked it out.
She's had it twice.
She should have just gone.
Yep. And, you know, the other thing, too, is when you go to the hoop here, you're probably going to get fouled.
Right.
Because she's got the position on these Laconia players. Let's see if they're able to make an adjustment here. And Gilmore will be more aggressive and going to the hoop.
Goffstown's called three timeouts in the first quarter alone. So Gilmore's got it in the middle.
And she got herself into trouble there.
Yeah.
Three defenders.
Laconia brings it down. Rebound fought for underneath. Laconia picks it up. And Durham picks it up for Goffstown and gets it over to Brennan. Pushing it up.
You got to admire
Walsh with it outside. Oh, she's right in there. There you go. Inside to Durham. And again, Walsh outside on the point to Brennan.
See that pass. Brennan has the pass into.
There you go. She's got the right idea.
Gilmore right there again.
Good ball movement by Goffstown. Just be patient. Look for the mistake and take advantage of the mistake. You'll be all right. Nice underneath pass. A scoop shot that time by Perez, but she missed it. And then rebound picked up by Brennan and out to Perez. Inside to Durham. And Laconia picks up the loose ball. Stolen by Walsh. She's going to go right to the hoop. And we're going to have a block. Good call.
So Delia Cormis.
Cormier, yeah.
Cormier, I apologize.
It's
your writing.
Yeah.
She picks up her first.
Going to the line for two is Walsh. First one's good. And Laconia substitutes a couple of players. Abby Crowell comes in. And Cheyenne Zapala. Second shot is good. Okay, again the pressure, and that's the end of the quarter. But Goffstown leads 7-4 at the end of one.
So Laconia has gotten all their points from Helen Totkis, number three, and the leading scorer so far for Goffstown is Kelly Walsh, and she's got 4 points.
It's been a good defensive battle at this point.
Yeah.
Laconia has done a great job. Goffstown's doing the right thing in the way they're moving the ball around the perimeter. When they get the ball in the middle, they can't put it to the floor in a zone. They got to look for the outside person's got to cut to the basket because the person underneath is coming up the trap. That will open up the layup right underneath.
I think what's happening is that it's either going to be Sierra Gilmore or it was Cammie Durham. They're going to be the ones who are going to be the receiver of that pass. And then they have to make a very quick decision on that. As soon as that they see that double team, they got to pass it off to the open player. And so far, give credit to Laconia. They've been pretty quick in terms of their reaction time.
Okay, now Goffstown substituted. LaRochelle is in the game now. She's playing that post position. Perez with it outside to Brennan. They get it into LaRochelle. She tries, see what that's what they're trying to do. And Walsh takes a 3-point shot, no good.
She followed her shot, which is good. You got a trap in that situation.
Rebound that time.
Right, good by job
Laconia,
by Goffstown.
And then they trapped her in a corner.
Yeah, so Walsh came down to trap her on one side. And good things happen when you do that, when you play that aggressive.
No reaching in, just position themselves so that they've got to force the ball out. Shot taken that time. Basket's good by Durham. Again, we're going to have a ball out of bounds on Laconia. A great job that time by Perez blocking that baseline, forcing the ball out of bounds.
Goffstown is playing a lot of freshmen.
There you go. There's the drive. And we're going to have a foul. It's going to be on Laconia. On Goffstown. That's going to be on, looks like it's on Durham.
Yep. Her first. One thing I like about Durham is that she's got good eyes. She sees who's open. That's a foul on
Perez. Laconia is doing a good job at breaking the press. Going to the line to shoot two. It's going to be Megan Gaspa. First shot is good.
Yeah, Goffstown's going to – they've gotten kind of burned by pressing. And they might just be better off just getting back into their regular defense, which seems to be working extremely well.
Second shot, no good. Rebound taken by Perez for Goffstown. She gets it ahead to Walsh, a little far. Gets it back to Perez, over to Brennan. Brennan covering on the point. Gets it over to Walsh. She's on the point. You're looking for that inside move. Perez back to Brennan. And over to Walsh. And we're going to have a 3-second violation on LaRochelle.
Again, another thing you don't often, a call you don't often see. But you know what? It's part of the rules of basketball. I'm glad they're calling it.
They're going to 2-2-1 press. And then they're going in man-to-man after. So good job that time by Perez. Shot from the baseline, no good. Perez gets the rebound, kicks it out over to Walsh.
Al, if I'm not mistaken, Walsh hasn't come out of the game, has she?
No, either has Brennan.
Yep.
Brennan Walsh and Perez have been in there since the beginning. Now, see, that's the right idea where to get it to, but it's got to be a quicker pass. Laconia steals the ball and goes to the basket.
Helen Totkis again.
And now it's 9-7. Goffstown leads by 2. Brennan kicks it outside. Knocked out of bounds by Laconia. Coming back into for Durham is going to be Jessica Edmonds.
Interesting. Goffstown had success with dribble penetration by Wallace and by Brennan, yet they haven't really done that in quite a while.
It's hard against the zone.
Yep. That's a tough pass.
Yeah, they kept you. Good hustle back that time by Brennan. Steals the ball, gets it ahead to Walsh. Walsh going to, she was thinking
there.
About driving to the basket, but she didn't have any room, so Laconia off their leg and out of bounds. So Brennan will inbound the ball for
Goffstown.
So
we got La Rochelle. She's another freshman. This team is laden with freshmen, right?
Yep.
Am I wrong here? She's a junior.
Junior.
Yep.
Kicked it out. La Rochelle inside to Edmonds. Outside to Brennan. Three-point shot.
Nope.
No good by Walsh, and it goes out of bounds. It'll be Laconia's ball. 1-2-2 press. Stolen by Perez.
Press worked that time.
Yep. Yeah, they did a 1-2-2 press instead of the man-to-man. Brennan with the ball on the point.
Open shot.
And Walsh takes it and makes the three this time. Kelly Walsh with the three-point shot. It's Goffstown up 11-7.
You know, as my good friend Bill Surrett says in men's basketball, good shooters keep shooting. They eventually start going down.
We got a foul on Goffstown. It's going to be, looks like it's on Perez. Be a possession. No, wait a minute. It's on
number 22, Allie LaRochelle. That's her first. And that's the team's fourth. Nice job by the referees, too, I have to say. Letting them play.
Inside, good double
nice
that
pass.
Time. Good drive to the basket that time, and La Rochelle picks up her second foul.
That was a great pass.
Yep. Good give and go that time by Laconia.
And that'll be a shooting foul?
Yep, shooting two. That's Hannah Dow.
Yeah, you don't often see double zeros.
No. The Robert Parrish number.
Yeah.
The first one is good. And we've got a substitute for Goffstown. La Rochelle comes out, and Britton Doucette comes back in. Hannah gets a second shot. No good. Rebound taken by Goffstown.
Again, fundamentally, great job. Her job was to box out the shooter, and that's what she did.
Yep. Good drive by Perez that time. Ball knocked out of bounds by Laconia. It'll be Goffstown ball underneath.
Now, we were talking before, Al, about like fundamentals, and these are just some really good examples that you have to do when you play a game like basketball, and that's box out.
Perez, three-point shot outside. No good. Rebound by Kelly Walsh. She goes into the
jump ball.
Into the paint with it and got tied up. Going to have a jump ball. It's going to go to Laconia. Goffstown leads 12-8 here in the second quarter. Now they're going with their 1-2-2 press. Looking for the trap at midcourt. Laconia looking outside. Two-point shot. No good. Rebound fought for underneath.
I'm surprised they're not calling 3 seconds on Laconia like they did on Goffstown, because there was one player who was in there for about 5-6 seconds.
Fouls on Walsh. Yeah, we're shooting, and we got Dow shooting two for Laconia. Crowd getting into the game a bit. First shot's up, no good. Now they're going to be encouraged.
Yeah. Al, listen, I'm one of those fans too. I believe that if I make enough noise, I could impact the game.
Second shot is good, and it makes it 12-9, Goffstown. Brennan with the ball.
I mean, so far, Goffstown really has not figured out this zone.
There they go, right there to Edmonds. brought the ball down. He'll stay with Goffstown on this one.
Good coaching. These are good coachable moments, though, because it you can't bring that ball down to let the defender grab it. Keep it up high.
Okay, and we're going to have a substitute for Goffstown.
A couple of substitutes.
There's a Peyton McBride.
Kaylee Gagnon.
So Brennan will take the ball out underneath. Gets it over to Walsh. Gagnon with it on the top. Gets it on the side to Brennan, and she dropped it out of bounds.
We have 4 minutes left in the second. Good overall game by both teams here.
Very
great
defensive.
Hustle by both. Yeah.
Good job that time by Brennan on forcing the ball to be switched to the other side. Konya is trying to penetrate, but they're not having any luck. Inside to Dow. Dow's shot. She turned around and, yep, got the travel. Good defense that time by Walsh underneath. Brennan to Walsh. Looking inside. Ball goes into Edmonds. It's stolen.
She telegraphed that pass.
And all the way to the hoop. Missed. Rebound taken by Edmonds underneath, and we're going to have a hold on Laconia. I don't know which player. It's number five, which is Abby Crowell.
And that's her second. A little under 3 minutes, 25 seconds.
Walsh with the ball. Brennan. Give and go to Walsh. Walsh takes.
That's a
Brennan's
shot.
Brennan's going to take her three-point shot. No good.
Good box out by Laconia.
Yep. Dow picks it up. Gets it ahead down court. Oh.
Oh.
Oh, what a great
that
job.
That looked like it was a great defensive effort by Brennan.
Thought
they're
going to
give
it.
Her a foul there.
Going to the line will be Ross for a sale for Laconia. Shooting two. I thought Brennan had her on that one.
Yeah, I did too. But once again, they get burned on that, not getting back in time.
Yep. So first shot's no good.
So these transition baskets for Laconia, they've probably got about at least four or six points off transition.
Second shot by Russ. That one is in and out. Rebound by Doucette. Picked up by Brennan. Looking for some help. Walsh with it. Kicks it outside to Gagnon.
There you go. Oh, number 10. That pass inside to number 10 was open.
Here, Walsh with it.
That's tried a sloppy to do a pass.
Yep, tried to do a give and go that time. Sorry.
Nice good. Pass.
Oh, nice play. Oh, and a hoop.
One.
Good job that time. A great pass by Walsh into Jessica Edmonds. She did a scoop shot, went in, and she'll get a
but
bonus
what a,
shot.
What a great play by Kelly Walsh, who drove to the hoop, got a double team, passes it off to Edmonds.
Her shot's good.
Big turnaround for Goffstown there. They needed that.
Quick inbound pass by Laconia. Ball goes underneath. That time they got position. That was by Gaspa.
But once again, it was on that transition. They're not getting back quick enough.
Brennan to Gagnon.
Ooh, got to be careful of that backcourt.
Walsh with it. Looking, trying to get a look inside either for Edmonds or for Casey Doucette. Brennan drives to the hoop. Up, no good. Gets her own rebound. Kicks it back out. Walsh has got it on the perimeter. She goes to the point with it. Gets it outside to Brennan. Takes a three-point shot. No good. Fought rebound underneath. Edmonds lost
stolen.
Control. She put it to the floor and she lost it. And we're going to have a foul on Walsh.
You got to give credit to Laconia. They're getting really good transition baskets. Yep. As soon as that ball is put up, they've got confidence in their rebounding, and they break. Two players for Laconia are breaking on every play.
That's Walsh's second foul. And Helen Takis goes to the line for two. She missed the first one. Peyton McBride checks in for Gagnon.
They're going to have to figure out Takis. She's obviously getting a lot of action. She's there, probably one of their best players.
Second shot, no good. Rebound fought for underneath, taken by Laconia. Trying to drive into the middle, taken from the foul line. No good. Rebound fought for underneath. And
another foul. So that's a little bit of lackadaisical rebounding by Goffstown, not getting some bodies on the shooter.
The foul's on McBride. That's her first. So now we'll be shooting two foul shots the rest of this quarter. To the line is Zapala. First one is no good. She'll get a second shot. The second shot is up, and that one's no good. Rebound fought for underneath, taken by Laconia. Good pressure up front by Goffstown. Zapala was on the
She dribbled the ball out of bounds.
She lost control. Went out of bounds. So Goffstown maintains possession of the ball now. They lead 15-11 with just about a minute to go in the second quarter. Brennan goes in. Kicks it outside. Walsh has got it. She gets it inside. Nice job by Doucette taking the shot. She's fouled. She'll go to the line for two.
That was good ball movement by Goffstown. I think what you're also seeing here is that it takes a lot of energy, Al, to play this types of defense. And I think you're seeing some of these Laconia players getting a little gassed because they're not moving their legs like they were earlier in this period.
It's wearing down.
Yep.
That foul was on Becca Howe. That's her first. Casey will get a second shot, and that one's good. Again, Goffstown continues with the press. Oh, I thought there was a travel on that one.
That's over the back.
But we've got a jump ball.
I don't know how you can get that.
I know,
but how do you do that if you don't go over the person's back?
So Laconia takes the ball out underneath. And we're going to have a push
on McBride.
On McBride, that's going to be her second. And we're going one and one, be two shots.
Oh, that's a type of foul that is just unnecessary because you're in a penalty now situation where you're stopping the clock and you're putting him at the line.
Going to the line is Gaspa. First shot is up. It's good. And the bonus. And that one's no
good.
Again,
that's another over the back on double zero. They don't call it, though.
Walsh gets the rebound, comes down court, drives inside.
That's a foul.
They missed that one.
Yep.
And now she's got the ball underneath, and we're going to have a jump ball. It'll stay in Goffstown's possession. 34 seconds left here in the second quarter. Goffstown leads 16-12. Brennan will inbound the ball.
Got to call a timeout if you're not going to throw it in.
Oh, knocked out of bounds by Laconia.
Goffstown might need to work on it.
They
might
need to the ball.
They might need to work on the inbounds play.
Yeah, they got to come to the ball.
Yep.
Okay, Brennan's got the ball on the point.
Got about 30 seconds left in the half here.
Brennan looking.
She's got to be careful.
Trying to get inside. She's got it to Walsh. Walsh going to take the shot. It's a two-point shot. Her foot was on the line, but the basket is good. Good pressure by Goffstown. Three-point shot by Laconia. No good. Rebound by Brennan. She takes it underneath.
Look to pass out of this.
5 seconds left. In the corner.
Shoot it.
Brooke Bride shoots, and she's fouled.
She got fouled
the buzzer went off. So she'll be going to the line to shoot two.
Good awareness by McBride to put that ball up.
She'll get two shots.
Gotta take her time. Gotta take her time.
Yep. And she'll get a second. And that one's good. So now Goffstown leads 19-12 here at halftime. I think we've seen some good defense on the Laconia end and forcing Goffstown to stay outside. Goffstown hasn't been able to figure out. They've got the idea where to get the ball to.
Yeah.
But they haven't gotten inside yet.
Yeah, I agree. So we're going to take a little bit of a break, yep. Al, and we'll come back for the second half. So, Al, we're back here starting the second half.
Good job that time by Good job that time by Brennan forcing that pass off. Brennan takes the ball up court to Goffstown. Over to Walsh. Cross-court pass to Perez. Two-point shot, no good. Walsh with the rebound, fought for underneath. Picked up on the loose ball by Edmonds.
You know what's interesting? I have to say that
Walsh steals it and goes to the hoop, and we're going to have a foul on Laconia.
You know, I guess it's tough being a referee, but on that particular play that we just saw, they weren't too quick to call jump ball in that situation.
Yep. Goffstown gets it in. Edmonds tries to get it out front.
You got to be really careful on that pass.
And it's knocked out of bounds by Laconia. Goffstown will inbound the ball. They get it into the backcourt. Brennan over to Perez, back to Brennan, tries to get it, she goes
the
inside
ball is,
Edmonds,
Walsh
and we're going to have a foul.
Walsh is wide open for the shot. They've got to get that ball rotated over to her.
That foul's on Zapala.
That's her third, I believe.
They've got it listed as her second. Corner. Three-point shot that time by Doucette. Goffstown opens up a 10-point lead, 22-12. They continue to full-court pressure.
Get up there.
And Laconia gets it over the timeline. Kick it back outside. No good. Rebound fought for. Picked up by Laconia. Loose ball. Okay, Goffstown goes into man-to-man. Trying to drive
it's
inside. We're going to have a push.
On Walsh, I think. Nope, that's not on Walsh. That's going to be on Doucette, her second.
I think it was on the block underneath.
Yeah.
Good job that time by Doucette.
Yeah, good hands.
Edmonds. Edmonds, yeah. I'm sorry. Laconia inbounds the ball. Zapala, give and go. It's a nice play that time. Tatakas.
It's almost like a backdoor cut on that one, right?
Yep. Brennan to Walsh. Walsh looking to drive. Inside. Nice job that time to get it inside to Edmonds.
She got pushed. I think she got pushed before she put the ball up, but no, they're going to say that's shooting foul.
Nope.
Oh, no, they're not. Underneath. Okay.
So Kirk goes out.
So Crowell has the one who has four fouls.
A three-point shot that time, again by Britt Doucette. Again, full-court pressure by Glasstown. Laconia breaks the press. They get it into the paint. Shot no good. Rebound,
nice rebound
taken by Edmonds underneath. Brennan in trouble. Gets it outside to Walsh. Back out. Doucette.
Over to Perez.
Perez, and she's got the ball. Whoa. Sapala trying to pick it up for Laconia. She takes the outside shot. No good. Rebound taken by
That was
Sale
a long rebound. Didn't have a prayer
Laconia.
On that one.
Whoa. Long shot that time. Rebound taken by Walsh. Now see, that should have been a jump ball.
Yep. That's
Brennan
a foul.
Goes to the hoop. Draws a foul against Crowell.
Goffstown's come out rather aggressively on the offense, which is nice to see.
Is that Crowell's fourth?
If it is number
five,
it could be number five on her, because before it showed four fouls.
Showing four on the board.
Okay.
So Goffstown leads 25-14 here in the early in the third period.
Yeah, you'll recall when she had her other foul, I looked up at the board and it showed four.
Yeah. I noticed that tonight Goffstown hasn't gone deep into their bench as they did the other night. They went deep early.
Yeah.
Got a lot of rest, but you haven't seen Brennan come out the whole game, and neither has Walsh. They've played the whole game tonight.
I tell you, I'm sure that the coach is going to look. There's a lot of good teachable moments so far from what we've seen. One thing that I noticed with Goffstown is also they need to be careful of their passing lanes. They're not really looking, and they're throwing it, into traffic on some of these passes. So if you fake the pass and someone cuts, you're going to have a lot of open layups.
Right. So Brennan will go to the line to shoot two. First shot is up, it's good. Her second shot. And that's off the rim, picked up by Laconia.
Good job getting
it out. Kicked out quickly. Again, Laconia looking to try to get the ball inside. They have no one down low, but they're keeping everyone up high. Here's a nice give and go that time by Laconia. And the ball is knocked out of bounds by Goffstown.
Yeah, good job by Perez to get position there, but she's got to come up with the ball.
Ball's good. Knocked out of bounds and stays
good
here.
Good hustle by Walsh.
So it'll be Laconia ball.
Again, she's got to defend the pass to the inside, which is what she needs
Sapala
to do.
With it. Left-handed hook shot goes in.
That's their second bucket of the
26-16, Goffstown leads. Brennan over to Perez. Inside to Edmonds. Back outside to Perez for three. No good. Rebound fought for underneath.
That's going to stay white.
By Doucette and or Edmonds, and the ball goes out of bounds.
Edmonds had good position on that.
Yeah. So it'll be Goffstown ball under the basket. Brennan will inbound. Looking for some help. Gets Perez on the outside. Over to Edmonds. She drives the lane. Loses control. Goes out of bounds. Off of Goffstown. Could be a Laconia ball.
You're going to get a
substitute. Gilmore comes in to give Edmonds a break. Goffstown again with full court pressure. Ball comes in.
Nice job by double zero.
Yep, that's Dow. Goes the full length of the court, missed the layup. Rebound fought for underneath by Laconia by Takas. She picks it up and puts it in.
So I'm not who had Takas, but they didn't box out on that one.
Edmonds with it. Stops, takes a three off the bank, no good. Goes into the paint. Lapala picks it up, kicks it out quickly. Ball's knocked out of bounds by Goffstown.
And Brandon couldn't grab a hold of it. So right now, Goffstown's up by eight. Momentum seems to be shifting a little bit towards Laconia here.
Good give and go that time underneath
Might
the basket.
Might call a timeout pretty soon.
And now Laconia down by six. Goffstown with the ball. Walsh to Perez.
Back Dangerous pass.
In the middle to Gilmore. She kicks it out to Doucette. Casey gets it back over to Brennan. Brennan drives all the way through and there's going to be a foul.
Good things happen when you drive to the hoop. Right
now. The foul's on double zero on Dow.
Yeah, so right now, Laconia, I think that was their fourth or fifth, that's their fifth team foul to Goffstown's one. So here she shoots her first one, misses it. But this bodes well for Goffstown in the sense that, you know, they'll be in the one-on-one pretty shortly. So they got to continue to be aggressive offensively, go to the hoop.
Durham comes in for a Doucette. Second shot for Brennan. That one's good. Laconia inbounds the ball. Full court pressure. They get off. Drive to the hoop. Great rebound underneath that time by Dow for Laconia. And she'll go to the line to shoot two. The foul, was it on Perez? No, it's on Durham. So that's her second. And we'll have two shots by Dow for Laconia. First one's up. Touches the front of the rim and rolls in. And a second one. And does the same thing. So we got a timeout by Laconia. We got a 30-second timeout.
This is good for Goffstown as well to try to regroup. They had a little, I think it was 11 or 12 point
yeah,
lead.
12.
Now it's down to 5 point lead.
Yeah,
they came out very aggressive, Alan, that to start the second half, and they've since simmered down a bit.
They're not getting anything off their press.
Right.
They'd be better off to pick up at half court
yeah.
and force Laconia to go in to an offensive setup to try to score.
The other thing too is that unfortunately, when they're putting up some of these 3-point shots, they're almost getting like no rebound. Now maybe it's because they're being cautious because Laconia is breaking two players, so they have to be more defensive minded on it. But they're not getting a whole lot of offensive rebounding opportunities.
Goffstown ball, and it goes out of bounds off of Durham. No, it was knocked out of bounds by Laconia. Nope. Off of Durham. So it'll be Laconia's ball. They kick it in to Zapala. Laconia's trying to look inside. Taking a 3-point shot from the outside is number one, Becca Howe. And it's now a 2-point ball
game.
And
now this is a game, folks.
Walsh with the ball on the sideline, and she's dribbled the ball out of bounds on the line. So there's a turnover, and now Laconia will have the ball, and we're going to have substitutes for Goffstown. The Durham and Gilmore go out, and Doucette and Edmonds come back in. Laconia with the ball. On the outside, they get it into the middle. Back outside, Zapala goes into the paint, takes a shot, and she's going to be fouled by Edmonds. Well, they called that one on Perez.
Oh, okay.
My bad.
That's her second.
They were both there, so two shots for Zapala. First one's up is no good. Hits the back of the rim. Then we'll get a second.
Goffstown has led the entire way, although now the lead is at two.
Second shot's up. That's no good. Rebound taken by Perez. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's going to go to Goffstown.
Another great example of you can't bring the ball down to your chest area. You got to keep it up high and create space, or else these girls are going to come in every single time, which is what they've been doing. They're very aggressive, Laconia.
Laconia doing a man-to-man press.
Helper.
Gets in.
Ooh, 5 seconds.
5 second violation on inbounding the ball.
And that's, we've seen that in this game a couple of times where Goffstown's had a hard time inbounding the ball. So momentum has definitely shifted to Laconia.
Dow.
She walked.
I think
she
it was
traveled,
a travel,
yeah. Key point here in the game for Goffstown now. I think they need to create something offensively.
They get it into Walsh. She brings it up the side, left side of the court, behind the back dribble, drives to the middle. And we're going to have a foul on, a pushing foul
number
on
three,
Laconia.
Maybe? No.
Number one.
Number one.
That's on Howe.
That's her second. That's the team six. So the next will be a one-and-one situation.
Okay, ball's knocked out of bounds by Laconia. I think Goffstown is going to need to work on inbounding.
You know, but games like this, Al, are good in the sense that they kind of teach you what your vulnerabilities are. And it's, you know, at a point in the season where you can learn a lot. She's got to dribble out of that.
Okay, Brennan ahead to Walsh. Walsh looks to drive, no room. Here, Walsh trying to drive to the middle, gets it outside to Perez. She drives, kicks it outside to Doucette. Brennan takes the three, long three, no good. Rebound taken by Laconia.
Opportunity here now for Laconia to tie this up or take the lead with a three. Well, she cleared out with her hand on that, her arm.
Yeah. We have a possession foul on the side. That's going to be on Edmonds, I believe.
Looked like the Laconia player tried to clear out with her arm offhand. That's Goffstown's third team foul. Laconia has six team fouls.
Good job by Brennan that time.
That's going to go white, I would think.
She knocked it off of Laconia player. Good hustle. Okay, Goffstown's calling their fourth timeout of the game. It's a 30-second timeout. Goffstown leads by two. Had a 12-point lead. Now it's down to two.
So as I was saying before, I mean, these are good games to have in the middle of the season where you face a team that kind of gives you a little bit of grief inbounding the ball. This way the coach can kind of work on that in practice. You don't want to run into these problems where you've really never been pressed by a team and you can't react. So good job, by the coach here, calling a timeout, instructing the players. It's really kind of, with so many freshmen now, you almost have to do this.
Yeah. So it'll be Goffstown ball.
Let's see what they can do here because, they've, like I said, they've had a hard time. Now this ball will be almost at midcourt.
Okay, Perez will take it up. She gets it over to Brennan. Walsh with it on the outside. She dribbles. Left-handed, drives right to the basket.
Yeah, that one was not a great effort because she had double coverage there, double teamed.
Going coast to coast, and she'll get fouled by Doucette. And she will go to the line to shoot two.
That's Doucette's third, I believe, if it is hers.
2 minutes to go here in the third quarter. We got two shots coming.
Dow is not afraid to go to the hoop.
First shot's up. It's good.
And this will be
substitutes for Goffstown. Brennan and Walsh will come out. Minnick and Saroy are in. Second shot is good, and we've got a tie game. Inbound the ball.
Whoa.
Good upcourt pass to Saroy. And she loses control of the ball. Laconia steals it. They come up court. Stop gets it outside. 3-point shot by Laconia. In and out. Rebound fought for underneath. It went out of bounds.
Again, I don't know how that's not an over the back either, because Goffstown player clearly had position. Looked like she got pushed from behind, but no call.
Laconia, we inbound the ball underneath. We got a tie game. Dow kicks it outside.
She walked.
We're going to have a double.
Oh, double dribble.
Good pressure that time by Minnick.
Yeah, Minnick. Good footwork out by Minnick, too, I'd say. Score is tied, Al, but Goffstown has led the entire way.
Okay, Perez and, will bring it up.
See,
looking for a little
bit of
help.
You've got to be careful when you stop your dribble like that.
Edmonds with the ball. Kicks it, tries to get it inside to Minnick. Stolen by Laconia. Laconia with the ball.
In that previous
trying
play,
to look inside.
You know, if Edmonds, you know, uses her other hand, she has a layup.
Cross court pass. Ball goes inside. Nice block that time by Doucette. And we're going to have a foul on Laconia.
And that'll be a 1-1. No, nope, it's
Edmonds,
a 1-1.
Edmonds will go to the line.
If it's on Laconia, it's 1-1.
Yep.
Cormier, right?
Yep, 32.
Yep. And that'll put
Edmonds
Jessica
to the
Edmonds
line
on the line for a 1-1.
Just under a minute here left in the third quarter. We got a tie game. First shot's up, no good, in and out. Rebound Laconia. They bring it up court. Pressure by Goffstown. 3-point shot, way outside. Rebound taken underneath by Saroy. She loses control. Taken by Laconia. We're going to have a foul on Doucette.
That's her fourth, if it is her and her.
That's her fourth. Team sixth, and we're going to have two shots at the line with Zapala.
And this will be for the first lead of the night.
And it's good. Laconia took the lead. Substitute for Goffstown, Gagnon is now in.
So coach is
Saroy.
He's given a breather to his two guards who played all game. So he's kind of has to do that and save him for the fourth.
Second shot, no good. Rebound taken by Doucette. Ball knocked out of bounds by Laconia. It'll be Goffstown ball.
The players on the court for Goffstown now, I know most of them are sub players, but they've got to be very careful to protect the ball.
Right.
It's the most important thing now is don't worry about scoring so much. Just don't turn the ball over, which is what they just did.
Yep. Good fought for underneath.
You can't spin, right, exactly. You can't have your cake and eat it too there.
So you got to be a travel or a jump.
Or a jump ball, right. So let's see if Goffstown can get this
ball
inbound.
Here they go.
They're very slow to react in terms of that inbound.
Edmonds with the ball. She gets it over to Doucette.
Hopefully they'll set it up for one last play here. Don't give up that dribble too soon.
Gagnon with it. She gets it over to Minnick. Minnick looking for some help. Dribbles to the side. Doucette drives the paint. Nice drive into the middle. No good. Fought for underneath by Minnick.
Goffstown ball.
And it goes out of bounds on Laconia.
There's only, well, it should be about a minute and 1.3 seconds. So it's going to be a quick pass and shoot.
Hey, Goffstown will inbound.
Shoot it.
Minnick has it. She takes a three-point shot, but it's no good. Buzzer had gone off. And we have a score of 28-27. Laconia has taken their first lead of the game.
Yeah, that was a rough
to start the fourth quarter.
You know, they looked really good, Goffstown, coming out of the half. And then things just fell apart pretty quickly.
Yeah, they started doing some fouling. And although Laconia's got seven team fouls. So it'll be interesting to see what adjustments he's going to make. He's going to have to put Walsh and Brennan back in.
Yeah.
I think if he came back, if he lays off the full court pressure and goes back to the half court pickup, would help him, I think. We'll see what they...
They outscored.
What adjustment they're going to make.
Yeah, they may outscored them, 16-8 in that third period. So,
hey, Goffstown will get the ball to start the fourth quarter. Oh no, I'm sorry. Laconia gets the ball to start the fourth quarter.
Keep in mind, though, that. Doucette has four fouls. She's not in the game, right? Oh, she is in the game. So one more and she's out.
Hey, again, Laconia looking, trying to get the ball inside. Drive inside, ball's up, no good. Rebound fought for underneath. And this will be, we're gonna have a jump ball at midcourt with Walsh.
Gotta love Walsh's
right to the floor.
Exactly, her hustle there.
And Goffstown will get the ball. With the ball is Brennan.
Well, we got to see now what the freshman duo, backcourt duo, can do here in terms of Brennan and Walsh, because clearly they're the playmakers for Goffstown.
Brennan will take it right to the hoop. Scoop shot, no good. Rebound taken by Edmonds. Kicks it outside to Doucette. Three-point shot, no good. Rebound taken by Walsh. She goes in. Basket is good for Goffstown, and they're back in the lead, 29-28.
And that's a hustle play, Al. Everybody on the Goffstown squad was hustling on that in terms of the rebounding and getting in the fray, and that's important for them. They can't rely on...
Okay, again, Goffstown looks like they're playing a matchup-type zone. Rebound taken underneath by Edmonds, or by Doucette.
That's it. Don't dribble
into
traffic.
Gets it over to Brennan. She'll bring it up court. They're looking to try to get it inside to Edmonds. Has to get it outside to Perez. Close to a backcourt violation, but she kept it in. Brennan comes back, dribbles, gives it to Perez. Perez stops and gets it back outside to Brennan.
So clearly Goffstown's being patient here, Al.
Yep, Perez. Gets it over to Walsh.
That's a foul, yeah. Didn't call it.
Walsh, good move by Walsh that time. She drives right to the hoop. Oh, what a nice play by Walsh. 31-28, Goffstown leads. Three-point shot by Laconia. Rebound fought for underneath, taken by Doucette.
Nice rebound by Doucette, and way to hold on to it and wait for a good pass.
Brennan with the ball. Looks like Goffstown trying to do a give-and-go situation if they can. Okay, with the ball is Walsh. She's looking for a pick. She gets
it. And she gets fouled.
Yep.
It doesn't
did not go in. But she will go to the line for two. That foul was on Zapala.
Yep, that's her fourth. That's what I have, but maybe they're showing only three.
I've learned
you don't always trust the scorekeeper on the
on the at the bench.
Yeah.
The official scorekeeper is not trustworthy. Is that what you're saying?
Listen, it's a I call it fake news scorekeeper. No, I'm sorry, I shouldn't interject.
Okay, Gilmore comes in for Perez for Goffstown. First shot was good. Second one is good. And Goffstown's up now 33-28. 5.5 to go. They get the ball inside. Oh, there's a travel.
Yep.
Good defense. They kept their feet
that
time.
Nice job.
Just hands up.
Yeah, it was good defense, especially by Gilmore. And she also didn't go for the fake.
Yeah.
So here's Goffstown's nemesis tonight, and that's getting the ball in.
Gets it into Doucette. Brennan looking ahead. Gets it up to Walsh. And good save by Laconia that time.
Wow,
good
nice hustle.
Yeah, that was by Takas.
Woo! Love it. Nice
gets
pass.
It inside. Shot, no good. Rebound, fought for.
That's a foul on Laconia.
I think they're going to call that on
really?
Doucette.
Wow.
No, it was on Edmonds.
I don't know about that one.
That one's on Edmonds. Shooting two. Or shooting one, I guess. It was a possession foul. Gilmore fights for the ball. Goes out of bounds. It'll be Laconia ball.
I love Gilmore's intensity and going for the ball. She just has to be a little bit more careful with the ball because she does tend to turn it over.
Oh, she gave Dow that. Oh, nice job that time by Edmonds. Brennan goes to the floor for that ball. Picks it up. It'll stay Laconia ball.
But good hustle by Goffstown.
Yeah.
These ladies are not afraid to
get to the floor.
Get to the floor.
Laconia with it.
Here comes a shot.
3-point shot outside. No good.
Nice
rebound.
Box out.
Fall four underneath. And
that's
and
over
Dow's
the back
be,
by
yep.
Dow.
Yep. She got her over the back, and we're going to be shooting 1-1.
But it's like we talked about earlier on. It's like if you do the fundamentals of boxing out, like you said, you could be even a shorter player. The only way you're not going to get the rebounds if they foul you in that particular situation. Dow went over her back, and now this will be a 1-1.
So Edmonds gets
four Edmonds.
Yep, her first one is good.
Excellent. And after this, it'll be double bonus.
They could end up by keeping the game in their favor by at the by foul line. Second one is good.
Nice
good job.
Free throw shooting by Edmonds. She sinks both her free throws.
Laconia pushes the ball up quickly. Goffstown gets back. It's all good job that time by Goffstown. Don't get caught too far outside.
Exactly.
Just enough pressure.
Right. Nice crossover.
And again to the floor.
That's OB Goffstown's
Edmonds
ball. So
goes right down here, gets the ball. Good hustle.
So it's his baseline entry pass, which has been giving Goffstown fits.
Yeah.
The problem is you can't have two girls going deep. And I have to say, in girls basketball, it's hard to throw that football or baseball type pass full court.
Edmonds with the dribble.
Nice
give and go.
Great
nice
play.
Job from Doucette to Edmonds. Woo. Good job.
That was
didn't
a
get
beautiful
the basket.
Entry pass by Doucette.
Yep. She didn't get the basket, but she's going to get the two foul shot attempts.
Or Britton Doucette. We apologize for
the hyphenated name.
Yeah.
First one's good. And she gets a second. Goffstown up to an 11-point lead now.
She's made the last four
pressure, and we got Britton Doucette steals the ball, gets it over to Brennan. Ahead to Walsh. Walsh gets it outside to Gilmore. Gilmore makes a move,
she gets pushed by Dow, I believe, and this will be a double bonus.
No, follows on.
Number
Zapala.
One.
Oh, no, number
Becca
one.
Howe.
I'm sorry, Becca Howe.
And that's her. I have ball.
Yep. That's her first.
I don't think I've screwed this thing up that bad. I had it as more than that, but.
So she misses the first one. She'll get a second. Ross comes in for Laconia. Second shot for Gilmore, and then we have a fight for the ball again. And guess who's on the floor one more time?
Number
Jessica Edmonds.
10. Man,
it'll
she's
be
been
Laconia.
She's been on the floor about five or six times just in this period alone.
Yep.
So that's the type of hustle that you want if you're a coach. See, this is what you don't want if you're Goffstown.
Right.
There's no need for you to go too crazy here.
Three-point shot by Laconia. No good. Rebound taken by Edmonds to Brennan. Laconia pressing. Gets it up to Walsh. She brings it up. She's going to go right to the basket. She does. Underneath, kicks it back outside.
The ball
it was
out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
Kelly Walsh has so much raw ability. It's crazy.
You're looking for a deflection that time. I thought the coach was right on that one, but okay, Laconia has it.
Again,
I
don't think you need to press, Al.
No. Walsh gets a rebound and fought for underneath.
Oh my goodness gracious. I mean, that is, you know what?
She was holding her hand.
She's pretty much holding her arm. Again, I don't want to be too critical of the refs here, but maybe they need to borrow my glasses.
Okay, Goffstown inbounds the ball again.
Timeout.
No, a five-second violation.
Oh.
What's happening is that the players are not looking at the person with the ball,
right,
and they're trying to line up their play, and
right,
she's already got the ball on the sideline.
Yeah.
So.
Or they're looking to, like, set, you know, that screen.
Good steal by Brennan. Gets it to Walsh. Walsh will drive to the basket. Nice play.
She's
fouled. She's fouled by number two. Looks like Ross. She'll be shooting two.
You know, we're in a situation now with under 3 minutes, three minutes, 25 seconds in the game. Goffstown also with this will be a 10-point lead now. Needs to start thinking about the clock is your friend. Start to burn some of it.
Gilmore comes out and Perez comes in her place.
Which is, I think, good because Perez gives a little bit more ball handling skills.
Walsh makes her second, giving Goffstown the 11-point advantage. About 3 minutes to go.
Yeah, so I think if
Goffstown's pressuring is a zone.
Right, if Goffstown, smart out, I don't think they need to press too much. They just have to fall back into their regular defense.
Right. They're letting her. Nice job that time by Laconia going inside.
That's going
to
be Laconia ball. Oh! I thought that went off on number 10.
Off of
Edmonds, but the ref didn't see that either. So we'll give that
maybe,
one to Goffstown.
Maybe he doesn't need your glasses.
That's a makeup call.
They get it in. Oh. Stolen, and then Brennan comes in from out of bounds and fouls Takas.
You know, there is no doubt in my mind that the coach for Goffstown is going to be working on inbound plays because one of the cardinal rules is that you don't inbound the ball right underneath your hoop.
Yep. Then I'm wondering, he's got the best ball handler taking it out. First shot by Takas is no good.
Oh, so you think that he should put somebody who's
I'm thinking that maybe he should get a better ball handler.
Yeah.
Unless the intent is to do a give and go. But that's not the way
now,
things are set up.
Now, if that is a foul on Brennan, this will be a one-and-one situation, taking no time off the clock, which I believe that it is. So Brennan loses control of the ball and turns it over and then fouls. So not what you want to do. But you know what? These are learning opportunities for a really young team that's pretty much has two, three freshmen that are on the court.
So Ross will go to the line to shoot. Is it one-on-one?
Yep. Box out.
And the first one's good, so she'll get the bonus. Cutting the lead to nine.
which is a very unusual setup style.
Yeah. And a second shot is good. The 8-point lead. And Goffstown calls timeout.
That's, you know, one of the tough things is that you call a timeout in this situation. Now you're forcing another kind of a setup on an inbound play again, which they would have had to a degree. But after a free throw, it's not as organized in terms of your defense.
Fortunately, she can run the baseline,
which she can't do, but she'll be able to do it now because of the basket. Which then begs the question, are they doing that on some of these? We'll see here.
Yep. That's one that can be confusing for a player if they're not used to it.
Right, on a made.
Was it after a basket or was it?
Right.
Especially from the foul shot situation. It's one thing when they score from the floor, you know you can move around, but when there's a foul shot, it's like sometimes you don't think of that.
Well, Al, this game has been a very good one. It's been a game of swings and momentum, and right now Goffstown had their big swing. You can see now that this is critical for Laconia. They got to get a couple of turnovers to get some buckets.
Goffstown
needs to be
now.
Right. Goffstown needs to play it smart. I'm hopeful that they have at least three good ball handlers in the game.
Yeah, they have their starting lineup in the game right now. So we'll see.
But again, you're right. You've got a ball handler in Brennan inbounding the ball, and she's not exactly very tall, so that's another issue.
She was looking to deep throw, but nothing there. Ball goes over to Perez. She takes it up court, gets it over. Oh, nice play.
He walked.
Oh. So nice job that time. Yeah. I thought for sure that Britton Doucette had gotten it into her, but she took that extra step. Okay, Laconia, 3-point shot outside, no good.
Now.
Rebound taken by Goffstown. Loses control, given to Laconia.
Over the back.
Yeah. And now we're going to have a foul on Laconia. And that'll send Edmonds to the line to shoot two.
You know, another observation that I've seen is that it's all about keeping the ball, and even when Goffstown gets the rebound, then they kind of lose a little bit of focus and they give it right back. So they have to kind of work on that a little bit.
First reaction is they get the ball and they bring it down,
right where they should be keeping it high and clearing.
Yep.
Remember, Roberts, that you was talking about our good friend Parrish.
Yeah.
That guy gave more elbows right after rebounds than anybody.
Him and McHale.
Yeah, exactly.
First shot by Brennan is good. Her second one is up, and that
and
one's
that's
no
not
good.
Brennan. That was
Edmonds.
Oh,
that was, sorry, Edmonds.
Yep.
And Walsh gets the rebound for Goffstown, so they keep control of the ball. They're playing man-to-man. 3-point shot by Britton Doucette outside.
So you don't need that, though, Al.
No. Stolen away by Walsh, and she is fouled.
Do you know what I'm saying? If you're up by 9 points, you know, I think you want to force them to come at you and maybe pick up a foul because you're going to shoot two.
Yep. So Walsh will go to the line to shoot two. First one's good, giving Goffstown a 10-point lead with 2:12 to go. Trying to make it 11. And it's off the rim.
She's got 18 points so far.
Taken by Laconia.
And again, you just want to fall back into your defense and make them exert energy.
And Laconia doing a give and go. Good, good defense. Good job. Keeping their ground. Keeping their feet. Forcing the ball to go out.
See, the beauty of this right now is that it's taking time off the clock.
Good job that time, but the rebound came out to Laconia. Kicked outside, trying to drive inside. Good give and go that time, but didn't make it. Edmonds has got the ball.
And they're going to call a jump ball.
They're
going to
call a jump ball on that.
Wow. I'm in the wrong job. I could make $70 refereeing games.
Here we have a substitute for. Now, I can see what they're going to do. They're going to try to get the ball down low to Dow.
Yeah. You want to try to pick up fouls here.
OK, Kick it outside.
Here comes a shot.
Three-point shot. Up, no good. Rebound fought for underneath. Taken. He has another jump ball. Edmonds.
You know what we're
she didn't
do
have to go to the floor this
I'll
time.
I'll tell
though.
You what we're going to do the next game we do. We're going to, like, put a pot of money here, a dollar for every jump ball.
Walsh gets the ball inbounds.
Call a timeout. Call
she doesn't
a timeout.
Have one.
Oh, she doesn't have a timeout?
I think they're all out of timeouts. They get five, right?
I don't know.
They
I'm
called three alone in the first quarter. So now Laconia has the ball stolen by Edmonds. Nice try.
That's Brennan.
Oop, my bad.
Yep. Minute 19 left in the game. Goffstown with a 10-point lead. Laconia is going to inbound the ball. And again, all Goffstown really needs to do is play stout defense right now. Let them exert some energy, get some time off the clock.
They're looking to try to find the shooter.
Yeah.
She's a three-point shooter. No good. Rebound fought for underneath. Again, a three-point shot. This one's good by Ross. For Laconia.
Again, the clock is your friend here. You don't need to put up shots.
Perez goes to the basket.
See, that's what you don't need to do. You don't need the points. You need to whittle down the clock. So that's
again,
a, that's
they're
a
looking
mistake.
Dow, three-point shot. That one's good.
You got to call a timeout here just to get your team going.
He doesn't have Laconia called timeout.
Yeah.
41-37.
Again, in that particular situation, Perez does not need to go to the hoop.
Yep.
All she needs to do is to dribble the ball and have Laconia foul you because you're in a double bonus situation. So you got to play head smart here.
Yep. They had – this was an 11-point lead. Now it's 41-37,
right.
A four-point difference.
But once again, I'm going to say the same thing. You inbound the ball, force them to foul you. You're going to shoot two. Worst scenario, hopefully you make one out of the two. You've still got a five-point lead. You're going to force them to chuck threes.
And they're putting two in a row.
Well, right.
Two out of three,
right.
I should say.
But that's the way that you coach the game, and hopefully the players need to kind of execute this. But it's not about scoring per se here. Obviously, if you have a layup, but I don't think Perez had a layup there.
No. She got the baseline, but she was out of her angle was bad. So now it's going to be Goffstown ball underneath the basket.
I mean, yes, you have to be wary of double teams and things of that nature, but, you know, so let's just see what. Now, in this situation, she can run the baseline.
Yep. Now she's going to be given the ball, and here she goes. She takes the long shot. She gets it ahead to Perez. Perez goes up, shoots, gets fouled.
Yep.
So fouls on Gaspa.
Two shots either way. But, you know, keep in mind here that only like 4 seconds go off the clock. And that's what you're trying to do is if you're Laconia, you want to elongate the game. If you're Goffstown, you want time to go off the clock.
First shot by Perez is good.
So now it's a five-point game. Very big here. This is a very big bucket.
Second one, no good. Rebound comes way out.
You don't want to do that.
And we got a foul.
Man.
I think she was trying to go for that ball, but she got the player.
Sorry to be exasperated here, folks, but if you're Goffstown, you do not foul in a situation to bring them to no time off the clock and put them on the foul line.
So now Laconia will go into the line, shoot one and one.
Yeah, this is like the kiss of death here.
First shot's up, no good. Rebound fought for underneath. Taken by.
She lost control of it.
Edmonds tried to kick it over to Brennan, and she lost control out of bounds. So Laconia has the ball.
I'm not so sure what Walsh is doing there.
Laconia trying to get it in. Kicking it outside, looking. Control. Gilmore's got it. Get it over to Perez. Perez is going to be fouled.
All right. Man, I'm getting more animated
than
if I was
Brennan
playing
will
in my
be
own
fouled.
Game.
Brennan is fouled. She'll go to the line and shoot two.
Nope.
First one's
gotta,
no good.
You got to make these free throws here. And again, you cannot foul. You cannot foul on trying to press. If Goffstown is smart, don't even go for the rebound. Just get back.
They're going to do perimeter. They're going to do perimeter shooting. So
right.
Unless they have the easy layup. Second shot is good. It gives them a six-point lead.
And I don't agree with this, but maybe that's what they're used to doing.
Well, they're just given putting, as long as it's loose pressure,
yeah.
Three-point shot outside, no good. Rebound taken by Edmonds. And she's fouled that time by
Al,
Gaspa.
You are so right. Edmonds, she's gets an awesome job in terms of boxing out, but she keeps the ball at her chest or waist area and invites a defender to come in and try to rip it out.
What's happened is they get a rebound, and someone's got to come back to the sides to help them out, and they're not getting that. So first shot is up, is good for Edmonds.
But Edmonds has had a strong game here on the free throw line, folks. She's made seven free throws in a row. Hopefully I just jinxed her. That'd make it eight.
Yeah, just made eight. 45-37, 18 seconds and counting. Laconia's got it. They're looking to take the three.
Just don't foul.
Good job that time by Walsh. She picks,
She was not established in the court. So in that particular situation, she needs to reestablish her feet on the court, and she didn't.
Yeah, it was a backcourt violation on her.
This looks like it's going to be a win for Goffstown, 45-37, less than 8 seconds left.
Dow kicks it over, three-point shot, up, no good. Rebound is Gilmore. She takes it outside. She holds
the
ball.
Do it.
And that'll be it.
So, Al, I'm going to go down and interview a couple of the players. What do you think? I'm thinking Walsh and number 10, Edmonds.
Edmonds, yeah.
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 All right. Okay, we've got Kelly Walsh here. Kelly, you had a really big game tonight. A little bit slow to start in terms of shooting, but, you know, what do you think was the key to your success for the team's success tonight?
I think we just worked well together in and out, and I think that we didn't have as many turnovers as all the other games.
Now, it seems like you guys had a hard time getting the ball inbounded. What were some of the difficulties you guys had there?
They were face guarding us, and I guess right when we got the ball in, they would trap us, and we wouldn't know where to throw the ball. And I guess we couldn't get past half court until we got it into our point guard's hands.
So safe to say that you'll probably be working on this in practice.
Yes.
All right. Well, great game, Kelly.
Thank you. Keep up
the great work, all right? Okay, we're here with Jess Edmonds. Jess, you had a super game. I thought you did a phenomenal job boxing out. You got a lot of rebounds. This was a pretty tough team, though, in terms of they were very aggressive on the boards, weren't they?
Yes.
And now in terms of my question for you is, how many times were you on the court? Because I counted in the fourth period that you dove for balls like 8-9 times. Is that something you guys work on in practice?
A little bit. We just try to practice like we play in games and go hard every time.
You know what? I have to say, I've watched a lot of basketball. I was super impressed with your intensity and all of you. I mean, going after the loose balls. I was mentioning to Kelly, you guys had a little bit of a hard time on the inbounds. What do you think were some of the issues with respect to that?
I would say just experience with one another. You know, it's definitely a new group of girls. So we're still just learning how to work with each other's strengths.
So what are your thoughts? You've got, two freshmen who are playing in the backcourt. I mean, what type of transition has that been for you?
Not really a big one, I guess, because you treat them like any other player. They earned our respect.
And they've done a good job so far this year. So great job tonight. You guys are,
five-game
winning streak.
Yep.
All right, let's make it six. All right? Good talking
to
you. So with the head coach, Ian Horstman. Ian, this is a great victory. I thought it was a really great game. A lot of defensive intensity, both Laconia and Goffstown. You know, what was your takeaway? What did you learn from this night's game about the girls?
I think we played a tough game because we did not play our best basketball, I don't think. We really struggled offensively, which is really our strength. and we're trying to pick our defense up at the same time. I did tell the girls before the game, Laconia was a scrappy team. They've lost several games, but all by single digits.
Yeah.
I told them at halftime, you can see why. The coach has got them playing really good defense. Their offense is a little scratchy here and there, but you can see how tough they made it for us at the defensive end. It was clearly like one of our toughest battles so far this season.
You know, I was talking to both Jess and Kelly. You know, one of the things that Al and I noticed when we were talking about the game was the difficulty inbounding the ball on stoppages. What do you think attributed to that?
I think that was the first time we have really seen effective pressure full court against us. I mean, I think for the most part, a lot of teams have played just simple half-court zone defense. We've practiced press breaks, but we haven't had an opportunity to really execute them in a game situation, and we didn't do a very good job.
Although
of that
you did in the last play, where you had a player running deep,
correct,
down the court, and a good throw,
yeah,
leading her. So overall, now this is your fourth or fifth game in a row? Five,
and I think
we've won
seven of our last eight, if you include the Christmas tournament.
Right. So Al and I think we broadcast your first game, and it looked like you were trying to find the right combinations.
Correct.
It looks like you found your combinations here. Do you feel good about the team?
I feel reasonably good about where we're at right now. We had a very difficult preseason. I had some personal things that meant I pretty much missed the preseason. So 2 days before our first game was when I got back. We had two practices. So we were kind of like a couple of weeks behind most other teams.
Now, one of the questions I know Al was asking is, you called an awful lot of timeouts early on. Mm-hmm. What was the reason for that?
Two things. Game strategy is one. Teaching moments is another. Sometimes I like to use timeouts, not necessarily for the strategy of things, but just to get a point across for down the road.
Yeah.
I think today I was a little fortunate. It did not come back to haunt me because I wish I'd had another one in my back pocket for some of the press break stuff.
But it all worked out.
It did work out, yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Coach, and congratulations.
Thanks very much.